reason why I never met that. I first started using this meth when I was 18 years old, when the first time I tried it, I was 18. From the very first time that I tried it, I immediately became addicted to it that day. So addicted that I spent the next 13 years of my life being a meth addict. Throughout those 13 years of my life, I've been arrested by the Harrelson County Police Department in District Hall County so many times that you can't count on both hands. I've had my doors kicked in by the SWAT team and drug task force at 10 o'clock in the morning with guns pointed at me and my 4-year-old daughter's head. I really laid in bed sleeping because I was trying to sell methamphetamine. That day I was handcuffed, took to jail in front of my daughter. While she was taken in place in a foster home, with somebody she didn't know, I didn't know where she was, and she didn't even know if her daddy was ever going to come back and get her. You see, meth will beat you down and beat you down and take everything from you. Meth has taken so much from me, it's crazy. I started off losing my daughter to foster home, being locked up, getting out of jail. I've had a good job that I love to do, making great money. I had it taken from me because of the meth. All my vehicles that I had a truck paid for, car paid for, bass boat, jet ski. I sold a little bit of that so I could afford to pay for my habit of methamphetamine. I even lost the $200,000 home that I was living in as a result of meth. But you see, it's not always, it's not. Losing all that stuff right there wasn't enough for me to stop using meth. Because all I could care about was how to get out of jail and go get that next high. You see, it's some of the physical things that meth does to a person's body. You see the pictures up here of the meth mouth? Some of you think those pictures are fake because they look so horrible. Come up to me after the presentation, and I'll show you the backs of my teeth, how solid and black they are, smoking meth and using meth. I've had 4 teeth removed because of meth. My memory is shot. Long term, this was during those 13 years, I can't remember nothing, or I can't remember the people that I met. Takes a toll on your body. Meth will control everything you are. It'll control everything you think about, where all you care about is how to get that next high. It'll control your heart, where you will have no emotions, no feelings for nothing, or nobody. I had a grandmother that passed away. I went to her funeral. I didn't shed one tear. Because that's how meth does it. After losing everything that I lost, home, the cars, I moved in with my parents. While I started staying there with them, I started stealing stuff from my parents. I'd go out to my dad's building, steal his chainsaws, or I'd get in his safe and steal guns from him. I'd go sell all that just so I could get my next fix. This last time I was in jail, my dad wrote me a letter. And in the letter, he told me how he was scared. He was going to bed tonight without taking his keys to his safe, keys to his vehicle, or his wallet to bed with him. Because he was so afraid I'd go in there while he was asleep and steal everything from him, which I've done several times. But you see, also, it's not the things you can lose from math, like materialistic things in life, like your vehicle, your home. Math takes from you things you can't get back in life. Something that you'll lose forever and nothing can ever replace it. In my case, it was, I wasted 13 years of my life out here running the street selling dope, doing dope. That my dad only got to see me sober for 4 months. By the time I graduated high school and got my new job, bid and got his graduation present every time. Those next 13 years, I showed him a way, but had nothing to do with it. So I lost all that time with my dad. So he died in November 2013, after 4 months of something. So for that one reason right there alone is enough to me, I think that's impediment. This morning, I'm 52 years old. I'm owned by the state of Georgia. I live at home with my mother. The only vehicle that I got right now is a work truck that my company provides me to drive back and forth to work. My credit, I ain't got no credit at all because I borrowed money at every finance company around. So you see, when I was told at 18 years old that nothing bad would come from math, that it was cool, that she's still great, she has so much energy, nothing bad would ever come of it. I'm telling you guys this morning, they lied.